7,200 new SHG groups have been formed, newly formed for the urban poor, and that commenced from 15th March, critical COVID time. New self-help groups for whom assistance get given, and they get benefit from revolving funds and so on to catch on with what they want to do for their livelihoods. So during these 2 months, COVID period, you have these activities which have happened with central government participating actively in these 2 months only.
Pravasi mazdoor aur shahri gareeb, ye charcha ka vishay pichle kuch dinon mein bhi raha, lekin main ye kehna chahta hu hamari sarkar ne pichle varshon mein bhi nikle kiya aur is samay mein to vishesh taur par hum logon ne आपदा राहत के माध्यम से जो फंड स्टेट डिजास्टर रिस्पांस फंड के माध्यम से उपलब्ध उनको हमने राज्यों को करवाया, ये लगभग 11,000 करोड़ रुपए से ज्यादा है, ताकि इन लोगों को उसमें से राहत दी जा सके, आपदा राहत हो सके, उसके लिए इस्तेमाल किया गया। और यही नहीं, हाइजीन का ख्याल रखते हुए 3 मील्स एक दिन में प्रति व्यक्ति के लिए इन शेल्टर होम्स में उपलब्ध करवाई गई, ऐसा प्रावधान वहां पर करवाया गया। और जो हमारे स्वयं सहायता समूह है, जिसको आप सेल्फ हेल्प ग्रुप्स भी कहते हैं, ऐसे 12,000 स्वयं सहायता समूह ने 3 करोड़ मास्क और 1,20,000 लीटर सैनिटाइजर्स का उत्पादन किया है। ये एक अपने आप में बहुत बड़ी बात है, और इस संकट की घड़ी में हमारे काम और ये बड़ा काम देश के लिए स्वयं सहायता समूह की हमारी बहनों ने किया है। यही नहीं, 7,200 नए स्वयं सहायता समूह इस समय में बनकर और शुरू हैं पिछले 2 महीनों में, और जो रिवॉल्विंग फंड सेल्फ हेल्प ग्रुप के लिए पैसा एक पोर्टल के माध्यम से हमने शुरू किया था गुजरात में पायलट प्रोजेक्ट, अब उसको पूरे देश भर के अलग अलग राज्यों में शुरू किया जाएगा ताकि इनको और लाभ मिल सके। आपको याद होगा कुछ दिन पहले जब हमने घोषणा की थी तो सेल्फ हेल्प ग्रुप के लिए भी 10 लाख से बढ़ाकर 20 लाख रुपए उसकी लिमिट कर दी थी, तो इससे भी उनकी कैपेसिटी बिल्डिंग में मदद मिलेगी।
There's definitely a lot of concern and a legitimate concern about migrant workers now going back to their respective states, and will they be there without any opportunities to earn their livelihood? So I would like to draw your attention to say that you know that we had announced the increase in the average wage rate from 182 to 202 rupees. I had made an announcement once earlier. Now, the question of these people returning to their states, will they stay without any provisioning? We have already generated 14.62 crore man days or person days of work generated up to 13th May, which is actually 40 to 50% more persons who have got enrolled compared to last May. So when there was no COVID, what was the number? It is at least 40 to 50% more than what it was before. We have enrolled all of them. We are making provision through the Rural Development Ministry to ensure that they get enrolled, they get work, they get the due payments. So work offered is now to 2.33 crore wage seekers, I think the data is of yesterday, in about 1.87 lakh gram panchayats. So the migrant workers who are going back, and if in case they are joining the MNREGA there, are being actively enrolled and provisioned through the respective ministries being done, and they are being taken. We've ensured that they're going to be entertained even there. They're not going to be sitting for wanting of some basic work. States and union territories have been advised to provide work to these migrant workers as per the provisions of this MNREGA Act. So we are continuing to monitor, and the work during the monsoon will also be actively taken up, whether for plantation, whether for horticulture, whether for livestock related sheds, related building, bagera. So on all of them, these workers who go from here are going to be actively engaged. So I just want that to be made sure. The annual actual expenditure till date is around 10,000 crore. Now, even if it's more, we are making provisioning for that.